You know, when things began to go wrong with my marriage, Annie and I decided to become rebels rather than call in the lawyers. We sure had to grow up fast if we were going to work out a way to keep our friendship. That's why I'm driving around at night looking for a place to sleep. Nah, I didn't grow up fast enough. As Annie and I were already into film production, we decided to make this movie about how we kept our friendship together. The script begins with us driving home after a few days out of the rat race, when all of a sudden, Annie turns to me and drops the bombshell that changed everything.
You know something? It's been two holidays away and not a bunk in sight.
Was that all my fault?
Puff out of the next toilet.
You remember the first time we were out here?
How can I forget?
You were fantastic.
Yeah. We dented the bonnet of the car, though.
Have you got a woman on the side?
Whoa!
Shh! Quiet! Are you nuts?
Have you got a man on the side?
Oh, now, wouldn't that be exciting? I guess I'm not a turn-on anymore.
Well, you're my best friend, you know? That's why I still love you, you maniac.
All right. Well, then, you come with me and we'll go and buy some fancy knickers and I could lose weight.
Hey, hey, hold it a sec. It's not as simple as that. Your passion has sort of waned. It's gradually slid away sort of thing. Think about it.
Just
faded away.
Well, I want to save what we had.
Fine, fine. Well, it's not about knickers, it's not about losing weight, it's not about rubbing all over ourselves and diving into a closet full of balloons
well,
either.
What then?
After 24 years?
Well, I still fancy you.
I appreciate that. You're not the same person I met all those years ago, you know? We could just stand there with and stand still and still turn me on, you know? It's like the siren, the horny siren has morphed into some sort of sister or like a mother who become my best friend. Yeah, that's it. I think that's it.
Oh my God.
Well, at least I told you the truth. At least I got it out. Annie?
You know, the French solved the problem by the wives having lovers and the husbands having mistresses. How about that? Could you handle something like that?
Hey, wait on a sec. Slow down.
It couldn't be anyone close to the family, no friends.
Well, I don't know.
Well, that's all right. I just know we can't go on like frustrated zombies, that's all.
You're serious, aren't you?
Well, this is serious, husband of mine.
You're talking about cracking onto other people, for Christ's sake.
Dating other people. And as I said, no one close to the family.
You're travelling too fast, you know.
So why do we stay together if the passion's gone?
Suppose because we're the best of friends and we like living with our children in the house that we worked so hard to pay for. Correct?
Correct.
I tell you what, it's a big risk, Annie. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling sort of scared.
Dad! Oh, hi, Mom! How was it?
Oh, not too bad, I suppose.
Hello.
Hi!
Hello.
Hi. Hello, dear. How are you?
Good, thanks. So, what's the latest?
Oh, nothing like a holiday to open windows in your head.
Thanks for looking after the kids, Mum.
Come on, get off. I just want you to go to bed.
Come on, Dad, we used to do this a lot.
Come on, Dad, let's go.
Just go to bed now, come on. Come on.
was that?
I think Gretel was about five, because that clam there, it closed, remember?
Oh,
she right. was she, terrified.
Yeah, that's right, and she raved about it for days after.
It was really good, wasn't it?
And listen, I might have got this little thing right. Have a listen to this. You have, I have, such fun together, and you feel, I feel, so good. Whatever, yes, it's true. Me and you. Well, bit corny or what?
Cute.
Hey,
whatever happens, we'll still be able to do this, won't we?
Yeah, I hope so.
But who knows?
Yeah, who knows?
Gutsy stuff, Annie. Why not just get a lawyer to kick the crap out of him?
Oh, well, because Judy is my best friend. And he's easy to live with. And I feel loved by him.
Oh.
And he cares for the children.
I think he's great.
And we've been together for 24 years. And he confesses everything. How many men do you know all like that?
What's your problem, Bruce?
Well, I reckon she's more into the deal than I am. It's like she's really pushing ahead, you know? Really going for it. I reckon she's really pissed off at me for not fancying her anymore.
So how'd you find out?
Well, I sort of told her she's becoming like a sister to me.
Sister, you silly bastard, why?
Well, I had to tell her the truth, didn't I?
It won't work. Know what I mean?
Where's Tanya?
Again!
Well, you're still doing this pissy little manuscript. It's depressing!
That's bullshit! If you do this again, you're out. What's wrong with you?
Hey, battle stations. He's back.
Nothing heavy. Stay calm.
If I want to see my woman, I'm entitled to it.
Take it easy, Ernie. You pricks.
Ex-woman, Jack. I said it's over. Why don't you understand?
This is my cafe, Ernie. Take it easy.
Tanya, I just want to speak
Jack,
to you.
Buddy, Jack.
That's good. Yeah. Anything to nibble?
You used to nibble me once.
Oh, don't rub it in. We used to nibble each other every day. Fantastic.
I think I'll go check the stove.
Hurt him by having him think that I already had an alternate man in the pipeline.
So that's where I was, in the pipeline.
Look, he's crucial to my family life. I don't want to get into anything that's going to threaten that.
Yeah, well, you know, some would say you should leave him, others leave him, thousands do.
Hey, I fluked a guy I still get on with. How many women have you met like that? Certainly not that woman you're divorcing even as we speak.
Oh, nice one.
Look, we could share some of life's adventure if you'll just accept my situation. Don't like it, huh?
Bullshit. Why go to all that trouble? Why don't you do it anyway?
Just don't tell the wife.
Just like the rest of us.
Don't tell the wife. Listen, mate. There's an instinct in every guy, all of us, that tells us to get out there and fertilise. Get your genes into as many women as possible. Just get out there and do it. Fertilise, okay?
Sadie, you're so crude.
Shut up, kids. Shut up.
Well, what do the females want, huh?
Security!
And to feel safe.
Hang on, kid, hang on. Mate, they want security, but they want security with the appropriate male.
The appropriate male?
That's the guy who's protective, who's providing, taking care of the kids in the cave, the whole thing, okay?
Yeah, like kids in the cave.
You're an animal, Tony. Shut up, Ken. Just shut up.
If I could just have a man to run his hands over me once a month, that would do.
Oh, Annie, I wish it was still me.
I know. I understand.
And I hate what it's doing to you. I feel awful about it. And the last thing I want is a dinner party tonight.
Me too.
We just decided to keep it outside the circle of friends so we could stay together longer.
Bruce?
What?
The question was for Annie.
Well, I know the passion wanes for a lot of people. Then we should give them room to move. No room to be free. Freedom nourishes. We should help our partners to become individuals again. You know, not stifle them into being someone that you want them to be. You know, open up to each other. It's no strategy, it's just plain old honesty.
You've got to be nice for a change.
Mm-hmm. I know that the truth hurts.
That's right.
I don't know how much.
Yes, I'm still hurting. But at least now I know what's going on.
Well, I know what's going on. And the rage is eating me away.
Well, then stop being a victim. Why don't you take control? Why don't you get your life and put it into a more positive direction?
Come on, Annie.
Annie, your arrangement is doomed.
Oh, really? Well, why don't you tell us about your little problem?
I got rid of my problem. I'm divorced.
Oh. That's just sidestepping it.
Yeah. Okay, Mr. Lawyer. Why don't you tell us what you're up to?
Why didn't you tell me the truth?
Are we ready for the truth?
I think you owe it to Susan.
Here's some more wine.
Donald!
All right! I was worried about retribution.
Whoa. Oh no, come on guys, why don't we all just get pissed?
Yeah, right, let's get pissed.
When are you going to tell the truth?
I was kind of waiting for him to latch onto someone first, sort of equal progress, if you know what I mean.
I've taught you well. Cunning.
I think I prefer to call it tech.
Oh, come on, the boss has been after you for years.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Now, when you get him in the sack, just put on a performance. Men love that kind of shit.
Oh, it's easy. Yeah, it's good. I can work from home or the office. Yeah. No, it's a good lifestyle. But I feel a little bit like a drone, you know? Have you been? Hello? Sir?
You going to wish me luck?
Oh, what for?
Well, let's just say I've engineered my first date. Someone outside our circle of friends.
Oh. So, when are we going to open a bottle of champers then?
I'm not going to do that. Not quite. You okay?
Yeah, I'm hanging in, yeah. So who's the lucky fella?
Carl Jenner.
Carl Jenner.
Well, he's having trouble, big trouble.
Yeah, I can imagine.
What can you imagine?
Hey, that was quick. You're doing better than I am.
What's going on, Dad? Mom?
Hey, wait a minute. Why am I wiping up tonight? Whose turn is it to wipe up, huh? Come on, own up. Whose turn is it?
Okay, I'll do it.
No, I'll do it.
I have such fun together, and you feel, I feel like shit.
So what are we after, Bruce? Tall, blondes, big tits.
Oh, well, if you really must know,
come on! What's the matter with you?
Well, I like a woman to be fit, and I don't get excited about women who smoke.
Bravo. That leaves someone like Tandy, slim, sexy, no boyfriend, and doesn't smoke. just pops pills, snorts coke, is totally dysfunctional. Mink.
Yeah, well, see, women her age, they don't take any notice of guys like me.
Sometimes when I call, she announces that I can't speak to the kids.
What? Why not?
Sometimes she reckons they're out. She says that in a low voice whenever she says it. Or other times it could be they're doing the homework or having a meal.
Yeah, depending on whether she wants to punish you or not, right?
Punish me? Punish me for what? She left me.
Yeah, but deep down, she's miserable.
Yeah. She's got the house, she's got the car, she's got the maintenance, she's got the kids. No wonder I need a nice woman in my life. I'm hurting. I'm used to all this. I can't express how I feel.
You're doing okay.
It's useless.
No, it's too much. Hmm? It's too soon.
Oh, come on. Aren't you afraid?
Carl, that's very nice. Mm-hmm. It might be the right time for you, but it's not the right time for me.
What?
Well, at least not yet, okay?
Okay.
Ah, this is the life, eh? Down to the sea and ships. 20 years of horrible master.
Hey, how would you like your eggs tomorrow morning? Fertilized or
unfertilized? Hey. Did you have a chili there?
Yeah. No, you mentioned it, and it was great.
So, do you think it'll be all right if we could see each other again?
Again?
Yeah, well, as I find you very attractive, I sort of get a bit concerned that if we were to go below deck and screw each other blind, that that'd be it. I'd never get to see you again.
Really?
Yeah.
You sound like a woman after a one-night stand, except in this case, we haven't done anything yet.
I suppose that caring and wanting to be with someone is not necessarily the province of a woman on a one-night stand. I mean, I reckon guys can feel the same way too, but it's not very fashionable for them to say so. Is that right? Yeah.
Well, I guess it sounds cool. Oh, hang on. You said you were still married and living with your wife, so how could this be anything but a one-night stand? Okay. Let me get this straight. You expect to have an ongoing relationship with me while you're still living with your wife and your kids? You cannot possibly be serious.
Oh, I see. So it's okay to have a sort of a one-off thing with a married guy, but there's no future in sharing any of the other values that he might represent.
Oh yeah, and what would they be?
Well, companionship. Someone to think about in the middle of a shitty day. You know, like a healthy man who arrives on time, considers you in bed and tells you the truth. What's so funny? You know, I mean, a good relationship without having to live together.
You're still living with her and you're still sleeping in the same fucking bed.
We're sleeping in the same bed because there's no alternative. What do you expect a guy to do? You know, go and sleep in the fucking garage?
Guys, hey, what's going on here?
We hit something.
Yeah, we hit something. This idealist hit the rock of reality, and I tell you what, it's not on the map.
What a shit you turned out to be. Come on, girls, we're leaving.
Ronald, what a surprise. I wasn't expecting you.
Hello. I just thought I'd pop in. Well, I'm a bit worried about this deal that you've got going with Bruce. Are you sure everything's all right?
Good on you, Bruce.
Yeah, thanks a lot, mate.
Another night of choking the goose.
Oh, shut up, Ken. Jeez.
Listen, stop telling me to shut up.
Bruce?
What?
There's a lesson to be learned here, son.
Oh, not another one.
Yes, mate, there is. When the hell are you going to learn to stop telling the bloody truth?
Now, if I was married to someone as nice as you, I'd never get bored. But let's face it, I mean, Bruce is not himself these days, not as we really know him. I mean, when I think about it, I can't even remember the last time he really laughed, can you?
No.
If you're bombing out with ex-girlfriends and you're bombing out with blind dates, crack on to strangers. Just front them. Hard in your mouth, so to speak. You know what I mean?
Don't listen to him, Bruce. He's full of shit.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, Bruce.
What now?
How about this one, for instance?
Listen, mate, I'm just not in the mood.
Yeah, he's not in the mood to get it. All right. How much? It's faster. Aren't you, Bruce?
Excuse me, there doesn't seem to be many spare seats around. Do you mind?
Looks like you're going to lose your moolah.
You guys are such turds. It's like we're just a couple of blobs. So why did you get married?
I guess I was a believer. I guess that I trusted that the institution of marriage would deliver everything. I didn't want any nasty surprises.
So, what's your plan?
I reckon a good part-time man is better than a full-time blob. I'd rather have loved and lost than never loved at all.
10 out of 10 for trying.
It's a pickup service. Would you believe it? You ring in and they give you an ID number. See what this woman says here. She's looking for a fella.
You know, a bit of throw the leg over.
Listen to this. Gentle, sensitive, reliable man.
Hey, look, I don't think I need to hear any of this, okay? It's a library. It's okay.
Gentle, sensitive, reliable man. You know why women can't find men like that?
No, I haven't got a clue.
Because the men who are like that have all got boyfriends.
Excuse me, could I just have a look at that?
Try next, eh?
You mean with this meeting somebody stuff?
Hmm.
I thought we weren't going to discuss your weird deal tonight, Bruce.
You're trying to control what they can and can't talk about now?
Well, Sasha, at least I'm trying to tell the truth.
Well, since we're being honest...
Uh-oh.
I think Bruce is brave.
Something which you could learn about, lover.
All right, I'll be honest. Too fucking bossy, Sasha.
Nag, nag, nag.
And being a kickboxer, sometimes we like, you frighten the shit out of me.
How's that? Oh, hey. All right. I mean, how can we hear this inspiring music, you know, with this shouting going on? Just don't realise this is a moment of truth for me. I'm going to go down to the newspaper office tomorrow with that tune in my head, right? And I'm going to send a message out there. I'm going to be like them. Yeah, they went on a mission, and I'm going to go on a mission. I'm going to find a girlfriend without lying, okay? What are you doing? Go outside, go outside.
Hello, Bruce. I did like your message. Gentle, sensitive, reliable. Hey, you must be so cute. I like food. I love to sing. I sing in church. I'm blonde. Well, sort of. Not slim, but I'm cuddly. Call me. It's Veronica. Voicemail box 3221. Bye.
Oh, Bruce. Call Lola. VMB 974 and 2.
Who the hell do you think you are, you asshole? What's wrong with a fat woman? Or is your problem you got a small dick?
Now hang on a sec. What did you say?
Well, I'm concerned about what you are like down there.
Down there? You mean my private parts?
Let's just say I don't want any ugly surprises.
Oh, I tell you what. Why don't we just meet somewhere? So I can flop it out on the table for you.
So why didn't you record on your outgoing message that you're actually intending to stay living with your family?
Oh, that's a good question. I guess it was because I felt I could do a better job explaining things more fully.
Thank you for the coffee.
Hey. Maggie, just can we...
Now you can keep going and breaking your commandments to God while he leads me to the right man.
Can you do that over there, please? The frustrating thing is, the ladies are prepared to take me on in the deal. Don't appeal to me. I mean, what's wrong with me?
You've got a big mouth.
I'll tell you what. If I was rich and famous, all this would be a lot easier.
Floor mission. Brave mission. And bombed.
How does that thing go again?
Shut up! You're mocking one of the most important things in a person's life. Yeah, finding someone to be happy with. You suck.
Watch it.
Because
it doesn't need one
then. Hi, folks. It's good to be home.
Hi.
G'day, Gret.
Hello. So, how did the ad go?
The ad? I flew a mission and I bombed. Oh. How's the boss?
Not sure. I think it could be too much.
Too much what?
Oh, He's a bit hard done by. You look tired.
Yeah. He'll be interested in a 55-year-old balding married man with a couple of kids.
A middle-aged fat woman who chain smokes.
So, both of them, eh?
Yep, mate, both of them. Mate, this whole thing could blow up in your face, for Christ's sake. She's doing better than you are.
Well, life's full of risks, Tony, you know.
Yeah, mate, we know that. Maybe you should think of marriage guidance.
Sit down. I'm trying to explain to you.
Sit down, please, Bruce.
Am I talking to you both or what? I just think it's an instinctually driven thing, you know, that's been honed over millions of years to ensure the procreation of the species, that's all.
That's a tired old cop-out.
Look.
Loss of excitement is a symptom of some disharmony deeper down. Sexual arousal is the victim.
Oh, God, well, there's nothing left down there. If you can only get it into your thick skull, you know? I mean, we're already living lives that are unnatural anyway, so, you know, nature's the victim.
Cop out.
You're copping out.
Bruce, yes. Let her talk.
I can see where this is going. So I'm going to write you a referral to a psychiatrist.
Oh, terrific.
Well, hello. You coming in? Hey, folks, look who's here.
Thanks a lot, Ernie. Thanks a lot, mate. Oh.
Gonna be there tonight?
Oh, I hope so. Yeah, that's
it.
Oi!
Oh, Jacko, how you going? Tall, dark and handsome.
Pretty boy.
Jack, cool. Don't!
Cool, Jack.
What's my woman going around with a pair of poofters for, huh?
Jack, you're losing it.
Oh, to your place for an AC/DC gangbang or what?
We're going for a drink. It's none of your business anyway.
Taxi!
Come on, Jack, come with us. You'll enjoy it. All you need is a bit of cock up your ass and get rid of the stress.
You know what? Disappointment. This is disgusting.
Jack, go home.
I suppose it was the alluring qualities waning. Now, did you get that? Listen carefully. The alluring qualities have waned.
Yes, yes. Very, very eloquent.
But the nature, even the quality of my love for Annie has evolved.
Changed?
No, evolved. Yeah. It's evolved into a, from that sort of neurotic, exciting, bonking mode during courtship to that sort of warm, cherishing, caring form of friendship. Togetherness, yeah.
Bruce?
Yeah?
I want to ask you something.
Fine.
Would you mind sitting down? Please, oh, sit down.
Not this.
Right here.
Oh, the game. Gee.
Now let us revisit the relationship with your mother.
No! God, no! What's that got to do with this?
Especially the absence of demonstrative affection.
I'm angry that nobody wants to know about stale men.
What do you mean, stale men?
Well, you know, men without passionate partners.
Men who can't fulfil their natural urges, like if their pride won't let them talk about it, and if they're past middle age, time's running out.
So, you one of these stale men?
Maybe. But stale doesn't mean dumb.
No, I'm not saying that.
We just live in a society that makes it very difficult for men to live naturally, I reckon.
Well, what are you doing about it?
That is being married.
What can I do about it without being called whole lots of filthy names?
Well, I don't know. Wait for the right opportunity. What do most married men do?
Then end it. Why live with the dilemma?
Look, I'm just asking you to give a little, okay? If I end it, then the kids don't get to live with their father. It's okay if we irritate each other, but so far we don't.
I know. Hey, you don't realise what all this on-off stuff does to me.
Oh, I get it. You want me to end your frustrations.
Listen,
and at a terrible price to my life.
No, it's not like that.
No, Carl, this isn't working. Sorry.
What? What? You're going to leave me? Is that it?
You won't boss me around, Carl. And I'm resigning as well.
Now, it's all in these books, but let me draw you a picture. It's no wonder there is frustration. It is a crazy design, because what we have is the vagina here, that the men are mostly interested in, and the clitoris, which the women are mostly interested in.
Did you really think I didn't know about that? Even though I do understand my wife's plumbing, I don't have the urge to do anything about it, you see? And another thing, and you can write this one down too, go on, you make a note of this. I still love her heaps. But she's not the same woman that I married 24, 25 years ago, you know? And maybe I'm a different man too. But why doesn't society generally talk about this sort of thing? Why do they bury it? Tell me that.
Then let me explain how we can rekindle your urge.
You're not listening to the damn thing I'm sort of saying here. It's instincts. All that is about instincts. Hello? There are galactic forces going on way down here, pal. Don't you understand that?
Let me see. What day next week suits you?
What for?
To help you sort all this out. You know something? You're a sick man.
Mom.
I reckon it took guts to put him off, though.
That sigh said a lot.
What did it say?
The deal's not working, eh?
Do you want to bail out?
Well, I haven't been doing too well, but, maybe a little bit longer, eh?
Come in! Oh, Mr. Cousins! Your son's spelling.
Yes. Thanks for seeing me. Sure it's okay?
Yeah, sure.
Just call me Bruce. That other name just makes me feel old.
Call me Fiona. Just use the other name if anyone's around. Fair enough?
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, the spelling. I think this is the material that you asked for in your note.
Let's have a look.
Sure.
Something wrong?
Oh, it's probably just a headache. I think it's a bit of caffeine withdrawals.
Oh, you poor man.
What happened with Miss Kelly at the school today?
Oh, nothing really. Just nothing.
But I thought you were taking all Dino's schoolwork, his spelling.
Yeah, but that's for night time. During the week, we've got to go over his spelling more.
I'm seeing something here. You fancy her, don't you?
She's all right, but she's just a bit young.
Sure, that'd be a first.
I just married too young. I'm bored. I've travelled, I've been married to the same guy for 10 years. We met when we were 16.
Really?
Everybody plays games. You know, if I ever have kids one day, with whoever, I hope they turn out to be just like yours.
Well, anybody who would know me would say, I wouldn't believe that I'd be speechless, but speechless I am.
Tell me, when will you be free for dinner?
No, she's too close to home. It's outside the deal.
Look, she's hardly in our circle of friends. It's not going to reflect on you.
Not now. The kids can...
Slow down. Stop it.
Come on, just hurry up. No fighting. We've got to get going.
Why don't we come to the same sort of arrangement? Spice things up a little bit.
Spice up, eh?
But they've been together for years.
Well, some people go stale earlier than others.
So what brought this on? Oh, I get it. You fancy that boxer with a tat, don't you?
Well, you stop it!
Why are you looking away? Bruce reckons that when they look away, they're lying.
Oh, why don't you get Bruce to move in? Better yet, maybe I should take him on. At least we think the same.
You want to take him on, do you?
Yes, I think I do.
Well, do you know what you're going
to
take on?
What?
You're going
to
take on the print of my foot.
Your violence
up your
and your persistence.
Behind.
And if it's that so, well, then I think you should just get out. Just get your macho shit and piss off out of my flat, you codependent cripple.
Ken, hi. Going sailing this weekend?
Look, the boat's on the slips, but we'll do it anyway. I was wondering, how are you feeling? You okay?
Yeah, sure. Oh, you mean about the deal?
Look, as long as you're okay. What about we sit down and talk about it? About a lunch?
I've got a meeting, Ken.
Look, I've heard about your boss, but I think I can offer you a better deal. You're still a good-looking woman to me. Remember that barbecue?
Fiona, you look terrific. Dean said you wanted to see me about something urgently.
The starters don't look so happy.
Don't look so happy? But isn't that what life's all about?
Not here. Not in this place.
Well, what's happened?
Bruce, I'm going to have to call this thing off. I don't want to lose my job.
Oh, don't do this, please.
I can't risk it.
I thought we agreed to be discreet.
But tongues are already wagging.
That close.
I'll have to take care of Sasha.
Anyway, what do you have to look so gloomy about, huh? What decent job. Home, wife and kids. Chill out.
If you're going to eavesdrop, you may as well get it right. Nobody listens to me.
Hey. I don't own anything. I live in a dump, work for this jerk. My ex-boyfriend is a psycho, and the only family I have is a sister who lives in another country. So don't tell me you're bringing problems.
Oh, hey, Tanya, you think I don't care? I'm just pouring out a bit of pain, just like you do. Men do feel pain, you know. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bruce.
Not enough froth.
Jesus, you're a fussy bastard. You've got lovely hands, Ken, but they do have a tendency to wander.
I like to be frank. You know how I am.
Yes, I know you.
Look, I don't want to see you get frustrated or unhappy. Life after 40 gets a bit tough.
Well, that's very kind of you. But the deal doesn't involve canvassing friends. And you are a very good friend, Ken, are you not?
Look, you don't tell Bruce, and I won't tell Lucy.
I'm sorry, Ken. But if Bruce has decided to tell the truth, then so have I. I won't deceive him.
Deceive? What do you mean by deceive? Jeez, Mike's got to be careful.
Look, I didn't mean to misread you. I didn't mean it like that at all.
Look, it's only lunch.
Look, a bottle of wine. Look, a trip to Tahiti.
Annie's solutions to his problems are usually violent. That's why he's such a loser.
Come on, Sasha, you insult my friends, you insult me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Another little gem from Bruce the Goose? Fills all your heads with this stuff about telling the truth, and deep down he's just a middle-aged loser.
You know where this leads to, Jack?
Huh? Where?
The police station, you moron!
I'll get you before you make it.
I'm sure you will. But tell me this, Jack. Have you ever heard me scream?
Scream? Another one of your jokes, darling. You stupid cow.
I'm gonna get an AVO out on you, Jack. Animal.
How many times have I told you? Get off the pills, Tanya, and we'll be okay.
You're telling me that the men pay for this, but the women don't pay for it. The women get a photograph of the guys, but the guys don't get a photograph of the prospective woman. Now, what is that?
That's right. Now, Bruce, take a seat while I just read your profile.
Something wrong with my writing?
It's okay. But, Bruce, you haven't had sex for 2 years. That's terrible. A man of your attractive qualities deserves better than that. You know, we can do something about that.
Really? But this $1,000, it's a lot of money. I mean, what sort of a woman do I get for $1,000?
Well, there is a $6,000 scheme.
Whoa!
Well, it's very popular. Very popular.
You know what? This is sad. This is just too sad.
You've got something to tell us. Just tell us.
You know how you guys change your friends at school as the years go by, you know? Well, some mums and dads change too.
Are you guys gonna change?
Well, not necessarily. Well, your mum and I have agreed to go out with some other people, just occasionally. Just occasionally, you know?
Cool. But you look kind of sick.
Well, I'm just tired and I'm got a bit of pain here. I'm going to go and see the doctor.
The doctors? Again?
I know. That was a doctor that checks out what's up here. I'm talking about another doctor that checks out what goes on down here.
This is getting weird.
You were right. It's stress, that's all.
Oh, is that all? Ah, how wonderful. Just stress. I'm liberated, eh? We all could do with a great big dose of stress
stop.
To make ourselves feel normal, you know?
Bruce,
great
stop
big
it.
Smack of stress.
Sit.
Just what have you been doing to get all this stress?
You really want to know?
I am your doctor. And your friend.
Oh, okay, well, you better sit down, eh?
Hey, what attracted you first to me?
What?
What was it that you were first attracted to in me?
Me?
Yes.
Your ass. I'm an ass man.
Ricky, get your hands off!
I'm sick of living with your bullshit.
Oh!
I'm gonna pack my shit and go.
Good then. I'll miss your animal behaviour.
And I'll miss your ass. What a shame.
I keep bombing out.
I've known your family for years. I never would have thought that you and Anne...
No. Look, that's all about marriage. It's unpredictable, right? You'd know about that from your own experiences.
No need to remind me.
What I'd like is a nice long walk with you. Your favourite male patient. You know, walk along the beach up to the lighthouse, picnic, thermos of coffee and maybe something stronger. What?
Bruce, I haven't finished your checkup yet. Now, Bruce, what I'd like you to do for me is to just lie on your side with your back toward me. Right. Now, just pull your knees up toward your chin. Okay, just try to relax.
You shouldn't have told them. I mean, what sort of role models are we? And with Dino starting to date girls.
Mum, Dad was right, I reckon. Why shouldn't we know what's going on?
Hey, what about me? I go out on dates.
You don't go out with boys, meaning get to be alone with them.
I do so.
What, alone? When?
When do you? So, did he get the bullet or did they pay him off?
Resigned. Mm-hmm. Shot himself in the foot.
But Nick, Tanya, your arm. Have you seen this Bruce?
He got into my flat. I'm getting the locks changed as soon as my landlord pulls his finger out.
Wait a minute, I thought that Jack was on an AVO now.
I'm calling Ronald about this.
No, Annie, it's cool. I don't want the cops nosing about
me. Hey, Sorry. You know, oh, this can't go on. You know, we're going to have to do something
about this.
It's
cool, Bruce. It's...
I finally worked it out. The mongrel who's been fucking with my woman is your damn husband, right?
You don't tell him to get his hands off me. I'll start to blow somebody away.
You got that?
He's not fucking her.
Sort of weird, kinky poof the stuff that you weirdos into. Hands off with
her. Asshole.
Good evening.
Who the fuck are you?
You toy boy, huh? You slut.
Just drop me at the cab rank near the railway station, okay? One day I'll get the scum that did this. You're not scared of me, though.
No.
Are you ready?
I don't want to.
You're crazy. A man doesn't forget a woman like you that easy.
It has to be my call, Phil. My life's already in enough shit as it is. Ships in the night, my love. Well, I certainly won't forget you in a hurry.
So what are you going to say about this bruise?
Oh,
Well, it's too big to be a love bite. No one would believe me anyway. So I'm going to tell everybody I waved down a cop car.
Yeah, and what are you going to tell me?
You're everybody.
Are you sure about that?
Sure, I'm sure. Why?
I don't know. That's just something different.
Well, yeah, Judy, I've noticed it's a nice day, all right?
Mm-hmm. It's a classic. I mean, as a villain, he's got plenty of form. I mean, did you know that?
Never had a clue.
Annie must be in a very bad way to miss one of my dinner parties.
Yeah, she was just exhausted, you know. I offered to stay back and look after her, you know. She said, no, go. So, here I am.
Did I hear you say something about a villain?
Sorry? A villain?
Uh-huh.
Yes, we were talking about a villain, yeah.
Who is the villain? Is the villain you?
Hardly.
You need some wine. So, tell me, are you married? Are you married?
Sorry? Married? Me? No. Are you silly? What about you? Are you here with somebody?
No, by myself.
Unescorted, eh?
Completely. Would you like to change that?
So obvious, eh?
Do we see each other again?
Yes.
When?
Tomorrow.
Perfect.
Okay.
See you.
Bye.
So, what's the plan? Are you going to go there separately, or are you going to meet somewhere and go in the one car?
Oh, the latter. The latter.
Oh, I see. We weren't expecting anyone, were we?
No. Oh, no!
Oh, look, Calax, I'll go.
No, you stay there. You stay. Stay. Get back. Oh. No, Gretel! No! I'll get it.
It's falling.
Go to the kitchen. Oh, go to your room, please.
But why?
Shh.
What's the panic?
What's going on?
Oh, right. Oh, Simone. I thought we were...
Bruce, I'm sorry. This wacko, you know from the house that I was supposed to meet you, comes out and has the nerve to say, what am I doing here? You know, there's a book out there called All Men Are Liars. Fancy that.
Oh. Ronald was right. Bruce needs his freedom.
It's like car accidents. You think they'll only happen to other people.
Up again. Same old story, Tanya. Just start looking for another job. You got that? No more chances. That's it.
How many more times, Tanya? How many more times?
Go on, you talk to her. I'm finished with her.
Do something about this. We have to sign.
I'm gonna have
do something. Right. Don't kill me. Jesus.
Whoa. Slow. Get her. Let's get her to the doctor. Any luck, she'll just need a finger up the ass.
Fine.
Slowly.
Social call.
Right.
Well, can I come in?
Yeah.
August.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
It's my best program.
Come on. I'm going to stay with Judy for a couple of weeks.
Why? He's going to wash my clothes.
No. Let me finish. I think it's best if I have a chance to think about everything. Especially as Dad has now taken up lying.
Then I thought you said you weren't going to lie anymore.
No, I said let me finish. We all tell lies to avoid saying what we really know. But whatever we decide will be for the best. I hope. But as usual, I need you guys to cooperate.
Look, if that's what this is all about, you know, why don't I leave? I was the one that told the lie.
What lie?
It's about that woman who came to the door.
She's right out of it now. Out of the picture.
You're not lying now, are you, Dad?
No, I'm not lying now.
But where will you go, Daddy?
It's Bruce.
Hey, Bruce, it's Tony.
What?
Listen, mate, I've got a real problem. I really apologise, but I just cannot do this thing tonight. I just can't.
Oh, mate, Tony, give me a break, will you? I've just arrived in the car park, for Christ's sake.
Mate, I got a bit of pussy on board, so just forget it.
Right. Got a Ricky's. Looking for Ricky.
Oh, he's at his mum's.
Oh no. You okay for a lift? You want a lift home or something?
Yeah, do you mind?
No,
that'd be great.
Go for it. Let's go.
Thanks.
I was just sort of trying to get a bit of a doss down at Ricky's place, you know. How have you been? You must have been through a hell of a day.
A few uppers do the trick.
A few uppers, eh? Right.
No, I really appreciate this. Sure, it's okay.
Well, the couch is just possible. Just don't look at all the other shit in here.
Yeah, I really thought that was cunning, leaving the car up the road a bit.
Well, he's still going to stalk around, Bruce. We're going to have to watch our backs.
I think I'll just give home a bit of a call and let him know what's going on, eh?
Yeah. And then you can let me know. Deadline.
Mm-hmm. What time do you start?
Saturdays. Start late, work late, no life.
I'll change it. Say, has Ricky found anybody else to take your place yet?
Nah, it's bluffing.
Yeah, but what happens if he's not?
Thought about what you said.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I could do.
Where?
They wouldn't want me.
Why not?
Don't have the right pieces of paper.
Oh, stuff qualifications. Get together all that wonderful stuff about your practical experience. And then all that creative work on the menus. We're going to have to be quick to get this application in time.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. And we'll put together a really nice CV and rehearse the interview.
Rehearse?
Yep. Just great.
Oh, huge row. Woke everyone up. Damn near broke the gate down on the way out.
We just came here to sort of help him clean up a bit, you know, and have a few beers, you know, that sort of thing.
No rubbish over the side, all right? Got it?
Yeah, sure. She can swim anyway, you know.
So, was that part of the rehearsal for the interview?
No, it was part of the job description.
Now, Bruce, this rehearsal thing is... I can't just own up like that, can I?
Yes, you can. Right at the outset, you just take control by saying things like, I have no tertiary qualifications, I've had years of practical experience. They'll respect you for that, for coming out with it there, you know? And then you do that other stuff about your creative ideas.
I must be mad.
Look, come on, sit straight. Let's go through it again, okay? Now, just pretend I'm the interviewer and take a deep breath to be relaxed, and you go into it relaxed.
I appreciate you giving me this interview, but may I say at the outset that I've responded to your advertisement in spite of not having the tertiary qualifications you asked for. You see, I have a conviction that my practical experience and creative approach to serving food to shift workers is crucial to this job. Well, I know what it's like to be tired and need good grub at a decent price. May I go on?
Listen, people, all we have to do is go softly, softly. The AVO is all we have for the moment, unless Annie or Tanya want to take out an assault charge on it.
No. Annie said there wasn't any witnesses anyway.
You two haven't a clue what you're dealing with here.
What are we going to do about our gear?
Bruce, no. Stay well out of it and let the police deal with it.
It's all bullshit anyway.
Hey, Tanya, hang on a sec. Look, just tell me, okay? Don't treat me like some sort of nerd. Come on, what's going on?
All right. Amphetamines.
Amphetamines? Everybody's into that hormone stuff.
Amphetamines. Speed?
Speed, you mean like ecstasy?
Uh-huh.
Oh, well, that's your generation, isn't it?
Yeah, but what about the coke?
Cocaine?
Yeah.
Jesus.
And unregistered firearms?
You got guns in there?
So no cops, okay?
Oh, Jesus. What am I doing? Fucking with some sort of drug pusher?
Calm down, Bruce. Oh. The guns are Jack's.
Oh, the guns are Jack's. Oh, that's all right then. Nothing to worry about. The guns are Jack's.
One, two, three.
So we'll need to move that guitar stand just a little way.
Playing too loud, am I, mate?
No. Making too many mistakes.
Yeah. Must be these tinny mics, mate.
Hey, these lyrics, mate, where are they coming from?
He's doing it for me, aren't you, Brucey? Go on. Tell him what's going on. I dare ya.
This is getting very complicated.
One more time, guys.
One, two, three.
Hey, Tanya, is it you?
I know he's out there, but I had to tell him myself.
I got the job.
Oh! Oh! It's wonderful.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. I can't believe it.
I never doubted you for a second.
Don't want me to run it, Bruce.
Run it?
Here he comes.
We don't need the cops this time, Ricky. We'll hide out the back, if you know what I mean.
Rock, get ready. You keep seated, okay? Rock, call the cops.
Don't worry, we'll get him later.
Shit. Well, what about our gear, huh? What are we gonna do about that?
Let's do it. He can't be in two places at once.
Yeah, but...
What?
I've got to do something on the way, okay? All right. Dino, how are you?
Not bad.
I'm
still at work.
Right.
When are you coming home?
Well, that's up to your mum. Look,
what's this?
It's a tape for your mother. Don't play it yet, just give it to her when she gets home, all right?
Okay.
Okay, you take care.
Yeah, but I don't know if you're right about it, Jim.
Oh, come on, Amy, you know I'm right.
I lied. You believe me?
I'm not sure I agree about this, Jude. I think Bruce and I are going to have to talk about it.
He said for you to listen to this.
I told you, didn't I? Oh, typical man. He's over the moon with this waitress, and he hasn't got the guts to face you and tell you it's over. Softening you up.
No, I know what he's doing, Jude. Now, why don't you take your twisted bullshit out of here?
Annie?
Go on. Please.
You are weak. That's what you are, weak.
He's out here, sitting in his truck. Yeah. Okay, mate. Bye.
Hurry up.
shot my woman without a dick, huh?
Get off him!
How's it feel to know you're about to die, you fucker?
Go on, tell him.
You're gonna end up with a very sore ring. Sick fucker. You do me, the cops are gonna get you, and you'll go inside for a long time.
That's crap.
Oh yeah, have you ever done time, Jack?
Stupid.
And when you go inside, all the cons are gonna queue up because they're gonna be ramming your ass, man.
Nobody touches my ass.
Jack, honey, I know a way out of this.
Fucking shut up! Listen. They would have heard those shots, Jack.
Shut up!
Jack, you don't own her. I don't own her. Nobody's ever gonna own her.
Jack, just leave. Just go now. Never done that before.
Never done what before?
Walking slow when I'm shit scared.
Tanya.
And that sore bump stuff.
Tanya, we could have been killed in there. We had a shotgun and live ammo, man.
That amateur shrink stuff? You win the prize, Bruce.
I don't think I can take much more of this. I really don't.
Trying to tell me something?
Tanya, you're an exciting woman. And I can't take more of this drugs, you know, and that psycho freak with this possessiveness and this...
Bruce, calm down.
Oh, dysfunctional personality, blah, blah, blah.
Calm down. You're all right. Look, everything's all right.
Yeah. Look. Just let me just say this, mate. Look, Tanya, apart from the drugs, you know, Jack's not going to believe any more of this sort of amateur shrink stuff. He's going to be back, you know. Jack will be back.
Listen, he's got more weapons stashed back there. All we have to do is point the cops in the right direction and he's gone, man. History.
There are some people that say you ought to just leave town, just split, you know, for your own safety.
And what about my new job?
Yeah. See, you're trapped. Look, Tanya, this is difficult, I know, but I can't have any of this touching my family, you know, that I really can't. I want to be a friend, you know, but to get in deeper, and how deep is this going to get? Think about it. Tanya, come on. Then I've got to find out if I've got a family to go back to. Well, Annie, so where do we go from here?
It's a case of to deal or not to deal. That's the question.
I've thought about it a lot, especially after you left. Maybe I just want things back the way they were.
Really? Okay. So did the deal do anything for you?
Not a lot. I didn't want the deal to upset the family.
Right. On a bit more delicate note, did anybody spin your wheels? Like, just a little?
No.
Oh, well, I guess nothing from here on really matters when you think that journey we've made together.
Know that little song?
Yeah.
So it's not corny at all. It's not even cute. It's lovely.
Excuse me. This may sound a little bit silly, but I'm sure we've met somewhere.
do you?
I'm sorry, I don't mean to sound...
It's okay. Don't sit all the way back there, I get a stiff neck. Oh, thanks.
You mightn't remember me. My name's Annie, and this is my husband, Bruce. Did you come here often?
A lot more lately.
Excuse me, do you mind? There's no other chairs.
No, take a seat. That's all right, isn't it, Bruce? The lady needs a seat.
Oh, yeah.
The more the merrier, I say. Wow, Ricky's really packing them in today.
Good coffee here.
What's wrong with it this time?
I'm not quite sure.
It's fine, it's all right. What do you think?
Fine. How do you find it?
Fine. Everything's fine.
Well, here we go again. Just when you think you've got it all worked out. Annie and I started out hoping marriage would end the search for the right passionate partner. Years later, we realized the myth. And it's been challenging, painful, to put together such a personal film. You know, I really don't think we talk enough about waning passion and how it destroys many good relationships. Okay, we didn't find the perfect solution, but to date, we're still hanging in there. So I guess you've just got to hope it doesn't happen to your marriage. Now, if it did, what would you do?
Yes, it's true.